Hey, toy fans, Rob here. I'm back, and today we're looking at something kind of old and kind of special. If you saw my recent haul video, I did just receive this T2 3D Collector's Edition doll figure from my good buddy Ryan, a guy who's given me several things over the years. This was something I was not expecting to receive in the mail, but as you guys might know if you've followed me for a little bit, I am a Terminator fan, so I couldn't wait to check this guy out. The box is very of its time, as you can see. It looks like we almost have a frame from the opening of Terminator 2 right there on the front, and they do continue that artwork all the way around the box. It's pretty big. As you can see here, the artwork's continued on the side there, and on the back we get a shot of the skeleton, the endoskeleton from the movie, and just a description, I guess, of this actual product, so you guys can check that out. And then on the other side we have another continuation of the artwork. So, pretty cool looking set. I mean, again, very of its era. I think they would handle this a lot differently now if this were to be made today. And unfortunately, the box is a little bit damaged. Not sure if that happened when the product was coming to me or if that's how it was in Ryan's storage. But since we do have a damaged box here, I thought we'd go ahead and check this guy out. I guess let me go ahead and open up the front of it as well. I'm not even showcasing the best part. There is the Terminator doll, I guess, inside. As you can see, it comes with two accessories. It's got some real fabric clothing there. And yeah, got some nice battle damage showing through. And then we have some more, I guess, a description of the Terminator 3D experience on the side. Now, this thing was, as far as I understand it, only available at Universal Studios. And it even has the sticker there at the bottom. So, pretty cool collector's item. But let's go ahead and get this guy out of the box and see what he's all about. Well, here he is out of the packaging, toy fans. And oh no. As I handle this figure, I'm reminded of one of Terminator's catchphrases from the movie Terminator 2, Hasta la vista, baby. This figure is just, well, coming apart on me. As you can see here, the moment we got him out of the box, his clothes just completely started deteriorating on me. He's got black on his hands now. The box, as I pulled him out, has got black flecks all over it. As I handle this guy, he just keeps shedding and shedding it. It all appears to be related to this faux leather outfit that he's actually wearing, which, while it was in the box, looked pretty nice. But I guess age just hasn't done this guy any favors. So, unfortunately, the premium nature of the figure is also its downfall, what, 30, almost 30 years, 25 years after release? So. It's a bit unfortunate. I was actually really looking forward to having this guy and handling him quite a bit, but now I think I might just set him on a shelf and leave him alone, and hopefully he doesn't shed too much more. But let's go ahead and talk about what the figure looks like. The head is actually an okay likeness for Arnold in the early 90s. I really like all of the Terminator endoskeleton detail that they've sculpted in here. It does look like the skull is supposed to look when it's completely exposed. They even get that little fleck of flesh that, or metal coming through the flesh, rather, that Arnold had towards the end of the first movie. Likeness could be better, but you know, for what it is, I think it's all right. Coming down, I do like the way that they've handled the clothes as far as like the endoskeleton look goes. These are actually sewn into the cloth or somehow placed inside this cloth. They're not actually part of the mold of the actual doll, from what I can tell. He's got a few areas of battle damage exposed, as you see here in the abdomen, here on the leg, and then as we rotate him around, he's got some on the arm as well. There are no bullet holes in any of the fabric that this guy's wearing, and of course, by the time he was damaged at least this much, he was already showing some bullet hole wear and tear. But I guess as his outfit deteriorates, we can just pretend he's got bullet holes coming to him there. He does have boots that appear to be removable. I don't want to pull on them too hard because that's going to make the pants break apart even more, unfortunately. But from what this seems to be, it's just a regular male doll body with all of the Terminator stuff, with the exception of the head, integrated into the actual fabric for the figure. I mean, it is a nice look. Don't get me wrong. I do like the way that this guy looks. It's just unfortunate the way that time has now ravaged this figure. He does have a couple of accessories. He's got his shotgun, which actually does have some paint detail on it, so I was impressed to see that. And even some weathering. That's not age. They actually intentionally weathered the gun there, which is pretty cool. Gosh, look at my fingers. On the other side, we also have some more paint detailing, a little bit of silver paint here. So, nice accessory there. And then we have his grenade launcher. Ooh, now I'm dropping stuff on the floor. As you can see, they do paint the grenade rounds in the gun, but that seems to be the only paint detail on this accessory. Fitting them in the hands isn't too difficult. The hands are actually the right size that they need to be. There we go. He doesn't have trigger fingers though, so very neutral, vanilla, doll-like hands. But he can hold his grenade launcher. And you can make him hold his shotgun. Let's get that in there. And there we go. Pose ability for this guy. His head does look left and right. That does rotate at the waist. He does have a rotation at the shoulder. It does hinge up, but the jacket is limiting that articulation a bit. He's got a single hinge here at the joint, and it does rotate at the elbow as well. Hands will actually rotate all the way around. There is a hinge there, so it's actually a ball joint at the wrist. Legs can go forward pretty far, but again, the pants are limiting it a little bit. They can go back pretty decently. Probably could go back further if it weren't for the pants out from the body. It seems to just be a ball-jointed hip all around. Looks like we have a single-jointed knee with a very strong ratchet joint in it. And then the feet will actually rotate, but they feel like they might do more, but the boot is just one solid piece of rubbery plastic, so you're not going to get a lot of articulation out of there. As I try to stand the figure, he's actually a bit challenged, and it's not because I've put a towel down either. The boots just make his feet a little bit bubbly, so this is a figure that's not really going to stand that great. You would need a doll stand to actually set him in. But he does seem to be able to sit okay. But, that is the figure. I guess let me get a tape measure, and we can go ahead and see how tall this guy is. Okay, so bringing in a tape measure, let's go ahead and set this guy long ways across the camera for you, horizontally. He does measure right at 12 inches tall, so this is a 12-inch tall figure. So I gotta say, age aside, this does appear to be a pretty cool Terminator doll. If you've got one already, I would say go ahead and leave it in the box. If you guys are out antiquing or going to some sort of toy show, feel free to pick them up. I'd say if you can get them for a decent price, pick them up, but definitely leave him in the packaging. So, thanks for joining me today, toy fans. I wasn't really sure what to expect with this, but unfortunately, it wasn't the happiest ending, but it's still kind of a cool item to at least get my hands on and kind of check out. I want to give another quick thanks to Ryan for sending this Terminator figure my way so we could take a look at it. If you guys want to keep up with me, you can just check me out at D21Beast on Twitter or Instagram, and I'll see you guys next time.